Now, because I'm man enough, I'll be the first to admit, Outlander happened to me on accident. Somebody was in my inbox every day and saying, Josh, you got to watch Outlander. You got to watch this show named Outlander. I thought Outlander was Highlander. And as a child, my stepdaddy used to come home, smoke his weed, and look at Highlander at 1 o'clock in the morning. I ain't want to go back to those moments. But then I typed in Outlander, and I realized everybody, and I'm talking to men, especially women, grab your man, make him look at this video. Men, you got to watch Outlander, because Outlander is about compassion. It's about commitment. It's about never giving up. It's about accepting responsibility and being accountable. It's about going through things with your companion at any given moment. It's about forgiveness. It's about acceptance. And it's also about endurance. And I mean endurance in every way you could think of. Endurance to fight somebody. Endurance to run for somebody. Endurance to be in the woods with the greatest ginger beard ever created. Shouts out to Jamin. Get that shave and carry a boar on your back. Endurance in the bedroom. And when I say the bedroom, I'm talking about I've never seen no man have endurance like Jamin. Now, I'm a man that when it goes in the bedroom, I do my thing. You know, I toots roll in the, okay. But Jamin got endurance to do whatever he want, when he want, how he want, and he feels for it. Endurance when it comes to Claire to withstand one of the most graphic, hate bringing this up, scenes in television show history, to endure that and remain not only a woman, the woman, the woman, he woman, she woman together. Outlander is a show about humility. It's a show about togetherness. It's a show about if we was playing Monopoly at my house and somebody decided to flip over the board, Jamin would slowly pick it up and his wife would put her foot on the board and say, you ain't picking up a damn thing, although she might have an accent because Jamin have an accent. It's like a reversal of like who is who at certain points in the show. And it's about time travel. I don't know how y'all can't get into time travel, but this is the most wickedest, most cheapest time travel show ever. They don't got to get in no machine. They don't need no flux capacitor. They don't got to pour no liquid. All they got to do is touch a rock. And I'm not talking about the rock that y'all think about. They put their hand on a rock and you can be anywhere. Wait. Do the creator of Outlander and the creator of Muffet Baby has something in common? Close your eyes and make believe. What if Outlander's really a dream? What if Claire hit her head on the rock and everything she's imagining isn't real, but like her deepest, darkest, like ideas coming to fruition? So what if this is more like a quantum leap than it is a reality? Oh my gosh, I just blew my mind. Oh my God, I just blew my mind. I'm gonna have to ask an Outlander group. Outlander also has a very, very, very passionate, aware fan base. They gonna let you know when you mess some stuff up and you don't get some stuff right. All I'm saying is, happy World Outlander Day. We cannot wait to see what y'all finna give us in the special extended version of Season 7, Episode 1. I'm gonna make it to Season 8, I promise. I don't know who trailer I gotta knock on or who table I gotta flip over, but Josh Prey coming. Damn it, Jamin, I want my kill. I want my kill. I'm gonna wear it inside out when I get it. Straight up.